Hey, what's up, everybody? I just wanted to show you that over there is LA, Los Angeles, from the top of the hill here. So that's it. I just wanted to show you that. Now we can get going. By the way, this video is actually an RWG CRV, a comment response video. I figured this would be a really good way to talk to you guys while I'm driving. And it's actually interesting, I think. Always a lot of crap on the road right through here in the last week or two. I don't know, they're doing something. My nose itches. So this is an official RWG CRV. So if you want to know what I've been doing, what I've been up to, well, I'm going to just talk about all sorts of crap. Now, it's going to be a little bit difficult to actually read your comments, but I responded to most of those comments by making videos about those things. So I'm not going to actually directly respond to comments this video, but I will prepare myself a little bit better and remember some of the comments that I'm supposed to respond to. So this is more of like an update video, not really a comment response video, so I apologize. But I will update you guys on the questions that you asked me in the last comment response video. So it's funny, when I do a comment response video, okay, I actually don't like posting another response video until I fulfill all of the questions in that. So I've been actually doing that, and I almost feel guilty by not doing some of the things that I should be trying to get done, but you know, life is like just so much going on. Anyway, so this is a comment response video, so I'm just going to update you guys on what I've been doing. Right now, I've actually been trying to get my microphone headset that I'm talking on right now. I've been trying to get it tuned up really nicely so I could actually talk to you guys while I'm driving. And I think I got it tuned in pretty good right now. I'm actually using a cheap microphone that I got off of some old device that's a couple years old or longer. It was a thing that plugged into the bottom of an iPod. And I've got that plugged into a cable I modified going into the GoPro that's attached to my helmet right here. But anyway, it's actually working pretty well, and hopefully it's not too windy or anything. If it is, I do apologize, but I probably won't re-record it just because of the wind. Anyway, so I just wanted to kind of update you guys on what I've been doing, what's going on in my head. I really want to get back to the RWG OSD CNC laser machine. I added some things to the name because it's now a CNC and a laser. Not a laser yet, I haven't done the laser. But I haven't had time to work on it. I've been building that coil winder, and I thought it wasn't going to take this long, and it's taken a very long time. And then I agreed to do a few other things. I got to learn my lesson, man. Every time I agree to do something, it takes me like 10 times longer than I think it's going to take to get it done. And therefore, everything else just sort of stops. I did get the new bushings designed and installed for my Rostock. So that is a very good thing, and that will be coming up very soon, within the next couple of weeks, I think. I've been 3D printing this other object, which is really cool. It's called the QSN. You can check it out on my 3D printing live page. It is there. You can see what it looks like. And it's an extremely hard thing to print, and I've successfully printed it many different sizes, but I haven't printed a full-size one yet, which is about this big. It's pretty big, and I'm working on that, and once I get that, I'll be able to make the video and finish it, and I'll share the files. And it's actually pretty insane, and I spent quite a bit of time on that in the last 3 or 4 months. So the other thing that I've been working on besides those bushings is doing Z-probe testing, because I want to switch over my Rostock to the Duet Wi-Fi. I have the first Duet Wi-Fi, the Duet that I bought, which is a 0.8.5, I was going to switch it over and put that on the Rostock, but I really need a Z-probe switch. And the Z-probe I got, I don't like the way it is. I want a Z-probe that Z probes with the nozzle, and I got some complications there. And so I've been on the Duet Wi-Fi forums, and we've been testing a bunch of different people's probes, and I put all that data in the sheet, the log sheet, and they've been cleaning up through here. They're making a heck of a mess for a guy on a motorcycle. Jeez, so dangerous now, all the trash and rocks and gravel and crap. I hope they wash it off soon. Anyway, so I've been trying to do that because it's just a waste of a Duet just sitting there doing nothing. So I've been designing the enclosure that I'm going to put the panel Duet in. And then I'll be able to attach that to the front of the rod stump. I want to replace it because I have it. I do not like the dirt on this road because it's loose. It's fresh. Don't like that at all. Anyway, also before I forget, really do not like this dirt though. Before I forget, if you guys like these drive and talk motorcycle videos, I've been publishing some of them over at the on the RWG Research Live channel. So if you like this kind of stuff, be sure to go subscribe there. And then also, it's kind of funny, a lot of YouTubers that I watch have been talking about schedules and trying to stick to a schedule and uploading videos in a timely manner and all this kind of stuff. I actually have been doing that, I just haven't mentioned it. And then the last 3 or 4 weeks after I got sick there, I sort of stopped doing that. So Wednesdays was sort of my days to upload random crap that some of you guys will love and some of you guys won't like. And just, like, I have a motorcycle video that has terrible audio, but I'm going to upload it anyway on a Wednesday, and it's just, I just haven't had the schedule to do it. But anyway, I like uploading things on a schedule, so I usually try to stick to a Monday morning. I don't know why, it just feels good. But the last video I uploaded on a Saturday afternoon on accident, because I thought it was finished and I had to reconvert it and upload it again. That one actually got a lot of views right away. I don't know, so I don't know, it's just, I guess as long as the view count is always the same, it doesn't matter when I upload them. If you guys trickle in over time, it's not a real big deal. But anyway, so I actually do have a somewhat of a schedule. Wednesdays are random. Mondays, I like to do something that's like a sequel to whatever it is I did last Monday. And then the rest of the week is up for grabs. I like publishing videos 3 times a week. But as of late, I've been focused on getting things done and making less videos. So that's what I've been doing. I've been really knocking some stuff out. Back to the OSD real quick. I'm going to restart that, getting that thing going, and I'm going to focus a lot of time on that probably after June. So it'll be another month or two. But I would like to get back into a rhythm of uploading actual sequel videos for that thing. So hopefully you guys let me know down in the comments if that's something you want to see. But other than that, a few other things that I really want to work on. One of them is the Tesla hairpin circuit, and I want to hook that up to a rotin coil. All right, here we go. You ready? Let's see what this thing does. Oh yeah, that was fun. I do gotta slow down though, because there's a lot of cops. So I don't know if you noticed, but the speedometer here versus the one on the road there, you might have to go back and watch it. It's off a little bit. I talked about that in one of my other videos. You can go watch it if you want on the RW Research Live channel. Anyway, hopefully the wind noise isn't too bad, because honestly, in my ears, it's very windy in here. I thought I had the vents closed so it wouldn't be so bad, but I don't know. Anyway, back to what I was talking about. I want to get back to the RWG OSD CNC laser. That's what I'm going to call it from now on, by the way. I'm not going to go back and retitle anything. I'm just going to title the new ones like that. That's an awfully long name, though. Anyway, Tesla hairpin circuit. So I want to hook that up to a rotin coil and use the rotin coil as a dead short, and then also use the other side of it as a secondary. I just want to play around with a few of those ideas. In case you guys want to meet me somewhere, I'm going to be going to the, I think it's called Science and Energy Conference. It's the one that the, how do you say his name? Aaron Mercati or Mercati or something like that. Paul Babcock's going to be there and a few other people I want to talk to. I will be going to that conference. It's up in Idaho. So I'll leave a link in the description. It's going to be coming on July, I think it's July 5th, 6th, and 7th. Or July 7th, 8th, and 9th. One of those. But I will be there. And if you guys want to see me there, you can come there. It's going to be a lot of fun. And I kind of want to play around with some of these circuits before I go there, because I want to talk about them. I may, if I see something interesting, I would like to bring a coil, the oscilloscope, and run the demo there for fun. Just something to do as a surprise. They don't know it, but there's no guarantees that that's going to happen, because I actually have to set all that back up, redo the test that I did when I saw some interesting results. And if I can do that in the time that I have, then I will. June's going to be a weird month. I'll be out of town a lot of June, actually. So that's going to be kind of weird on my schedule and figuring out how to get that to work. But I'll have like a week of time before the conference to try this, and I might try to dedicate that time to do that. Also, the month of June, I'm going to Italy. So if any of you are going to be in Italy, let me know, and maybe I'll try to meet up with you guys. Italy is pretty far away from where I live. I live in California right this moment, LA area, as you saw at the beginning of this video. But anyway, I'll be in Italy. I'll leave the link down in the description of the conference. I'm going to a conference related to cold fusion. It's actually related to absorption of hydrogen and deuterium in these samples that I'm working with and other things. And so, yeah, I'll be there. I'll leave that down in the description. So what else do I want to talk about? I talked about the RWG OSD CNC laser. I've been cutting circuit boards with that, and man, it just turned out so well. Really, really pleased with the bit and stuff like that. I did order a PEI bed. I got that in. I'm going to attach it directly to the... I'm going to get rid of the glass, and I'm going to directly attach it to the aluminum bed. And I'm going to also cut out... I'm going to use the RWG OSC CNC portion of this to... You guys should count how many times I said that. Anyway, I'm going to actually use it to cut out the groove where I'm going to put the wire for the heating element. So I'm going to make my own heating element on the bottom of that plate. And I'm actually going to cut the groove out where the wire is going to go with the actual delta itself. That is actually going to be very interesting, because I'm going to be stretching the far limits of the machine. I have no idea how well or not well that's going to work. I may have to finish the very outside by hand, because I want the wire to go pretty far out on the bed. But I don't know. I measured it all up, and I got it all sort of figured out what I want to do, and I'm going to try to cut that. So that'll actually be pretty cool. And then I bought some silicone rubber to put on there, like a silicone heater that you see. But I've been using this compound. Oh yeah, by the way, I made a couple of new hot ends. I made a video of one, and it was a big fail. And then I made a video of another one, and I modified it so much that I should just not use that footage either and make another one. So the third one is going to be the last one, and that's the one I'm going to use on the RWG OSD CNC. I have big plans for that machine on how I want to run that thing and make it dual extrusion and even tri-extrusion and possibly quad extrusion. And I want to do that with one nozzle, but I also want to have the ability to put two nozzles on there and make it a true dual extrusion. That way I can put one at like a bigger nozzle, put maybe 3 millimeter filament in that thing, And so maybe I could run an infill with the same plastic. I don't know. There's lots of options and ideas, but how often am I really going to use it? And that's sort of the question of how much effort I want to put into it. I put a lot of effort into the CNC portion of that machine and then realized it's a lot of work to set it up. But I went ahead and decided to set it up anyway and run that sucker and cut that last circuit board that you guys saw. And I was very happy with it. And so it doesn't take that much time. I just have to write a script so that the G-code that my... the G-code that I'm using for generating the tool path doesn't put the right code out. I have to edit it by hand, and it's a lot of work. So I'm going to try to write a little script anyway. If you guys want to help me with that project, let me know down in the comments. And I'll show you what it is, how I'd make it work. And it could be also used for not just circuit boards, but for, well, actually that code is just for circuit boards, that script. But it just converts everything over to where the G code that the, I use FlatCam. So the G code that FlatCam spits out needs to be edited for the printer to read it right. Anyway, I talked your ear off. I'm about to where I need to be, and so I will talk to you guys another day. So let me know if you guys like this type of comment response video or update video. I don't know. You're not just looking at my face. That's boring, you know? I'm pretty sure my clutch is slipping. Okay. I'll see you guys later. Peace.